We are chunkers. We're gonna organize the Bmobile Christmas line. Let me go inside.
We need a pineapple. Let's check. This was a nice one here. Nice color. See that nice color golden image on the outside. How do you know if a pineapple is ready? Go to the center. Remove the stem. If it comes out easily, ready to go. I think we'll take this one. Which one came first? The chicken or the egg? I still not too sure. All I know is Ponche or Crème for sure. Okay, so we have to select the best type of ham for this Bmobile Christmas line. Now, when selecting the ham, you don't know what type of cut you want. Me personally, I like shoulder, because shoulder has that all nice fatty content on it. And be honest with you, it's Christmas without a little bit of fat on the ham. However, not getting shoulder. I get in picnic ham, which is still very good. It's the leg of the pig. Has a significant amount of muscle inside of it. Muscle equals flavor, so we'll compromise with that nevertheless. So, gonna take two. Let's go. Welcome to Bob With Us, brought to you by the Bmobile 4G network. Guess what? It's the Christmas edition of Bob With Us right here. And you know, we can't have a Christmas edition without the ham. Look what I have in front of me. Ham looking sexy already. Are you ready to prepare this? What I was actually doing earlier on is just patting it dry. You need to do that because it has little slight respiration from the thawing process. And you could just do this simply with just a napkin by just removing some of the excess water. Looks good so far. And what you could actually see so far is I have some cloves already studded in the ham. I'm just going to continue with that. Why do we put cloves in the ham? Me personally, I think it adds that little extra essence of Christmas that we're accustomed to. Always smelling clove when ham baking at home. And I think that sells out the ham. And why not put it inside of the ham? We're keeping it classical and traditional today. So you just want to make a slight little slit and place the cloves inside. Maybe one more right here. You don't want to put too much. The reason being is that clove could be a little too overwhelming sometimes. And its pungency takes over the flavor of the ham. It's very earthy. However, it could go wrong if you put too much. So we have this ready here so far. I think it's looking nice. And need to cover this with foil. It's very important that when cooking the ham, that we cover it with foil, because this ham on the whole is actually about 10 pounds. And the rule of thumb is that you want to actually cook each pound of meat for about 15 minutes. So that will more or less average about 2.5 hours for this ham. I have my oven already preheated to 350 degrees Fahrenheit, in which I am going to put this inside to cook. And just 2 hours I'm going to cook it for, and for the last half an hour, I'm going to then glaze it with a special glaze that I'm going to actually show you all in a little while. And then we're going to stick it back in for the last half an hour of cooking. So I think we're in a gear here right now. Let's go put this in the oven. So our ham is in the oven, and we're going to let it mellow there for a little while, and we're going to check back on it in a little while. Time to make our bread pudding. Conrad?
What is it?
What you doing here?
You mean what I'm doing here? I come to Bubble, I ain't come to cause no trouble. I come to Parang, yeah. Bubble.
Where were you all the time?
I come from downstairs, though.
We have a downstairs down there?
What do you mean?
We come to the elevator?
Yes! You ain't hear the bell.
Conrad come to cause no trouble.
I ain't come
the
to cause no
trouble. Bmobile Bubble Xmas edition here. Conrad on the set.
Of course.
So, well, as you're here,
mm-hmm.
Help me now.
All right. Well, what?
We have been a little feast and we want to do the bread pudding.
This is
not no ordinary bread pudding.
Bread pudding? This stuff in for the ham?
This is nothing for the ham. Well, you know what? What do you know about ham?
This thing for the ham?
No, this is nothing for this.
All right, fine.
Banana rum raisin bread pudding.
You had mad rum raisin. Let me do this.
Tom, you paying attention, right? At least you know it's banana rum raisin bread pudding going on here, right?
Okay. So what
show some manners. That's Tom. All right, good. Don't get too attached. Here we're going to do. You got to help me make this.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, all these things. Hurry.
Bmobile,
hook
me up.
All right, relax yourself. So we have our ingredients here for our bread pudding.
Right.
We have our bread, we have our eggs, we have our milk, cinnamon, vanilla, raisins, eggs, the whole shebang.
Nice.
Right?
Okay, good.
So Santa can go be happy. Santa definitely gonna be happy.
I see it.
Right? We have our bowl here, so I need some help with this.
I see you have some nice ingredients going on here. I like this.
So what I have actually here is actually 2 cups of Nestle milk.
Right.
So I'm going to be adding that first inside there. In the meantime,
yeah.
I have 6 eggs. Could you actually crack those eggs for me? That's an integral ingredient in our bread pudding today because it's going to give that nice leavening power.
So crack them in there one time?
Crack them in the bowl, no? Please. Don't be so bold.
Right.
Definitely. I'm going to add a little bit of Maggi coconut powder to that. I think the flavor is going to work very well with the banana. That nice coconut and banana.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to marry very well. And we want to keep the flavors really, really local.
Christmas and marriage you're talking about?
It's Christmas and marriage.
Yeah.
You never went to a wedding for Christmas, eh?
Hey, no. Best wedding I ever went, let me tell you.
Mm-hmm.
Food like dirt.
Food like dirt?
Food like dirt. Food like rain.
Food like rain.
War. You talk about food?
2 cups of sugar.
Mm-hmm. 2 cups of sugar.
2 cups of sugar.
All right.
Inside there. Let me borrow your whisk now.
Aye, decent. I ain't bring it with me, but yeah, you could borrow it.
Yeah, boy, you whisk. So we're going to whisk this up nicely. Tom, you're getting this, right? See what's going on here? We have our sugar, we have our milk.
And you're creaming.
And that beautiful Maggi coconut powder inside there.
Right.
So we just want to make sure that we evenly distribute the powder inside there. You ready to go?
Yeah.
Just work real quick, boy.
It's me.
Well, finish it up now since you're going, so you're going in my mouth.
One pee, boy.
I'm going to add 1 egg at a time to this.
One egg at a time.
I want you to come and whisk.
Alright. I'm not too up on my whisk.
You can put the bowl down, you know.
I can put the bowl down, you know.
Alright, you just cook at home.
I just cook at home, but I don't whisk.
All you know to do is just come and slam people's set and farang, but that's Christmas.
Nothing is wrong with slamming sets. I just say. Right?
Beautiful. Nice. Alright, so a little bit of nutmeg inside there.
You call my name there, you know. Stop yourself.
I think nutmeg is definitely something nice you want to use inside there. It really embodies the whole holiday.
Right, beautiful.
Period. Looking good?
Mm-hmm, smelling good too.
But you didn't even remind me about the bananas, Conrad. What kind of friend are you, boy?
A good friend.
I have six hey, nice bananas here.
Hey, now, why you ain't put more nutmeg in this, though? It's smelling real nice.
My boy, a knife. The nutmeg is something on itself that you don't want to put too much of.
Why?
Because it is something that is hazardous to your health if you were to eat it in large quantities. It makes you hallucinate.
You serious?
I am serious. You gotta go easy on that. Around Christmas time.
That's a note to self, but I'm going and reverse that note. I'm going to put not begging me.
It's Christmas time and people is usually hallucinate when they drink rum.
You understand?
People like Conrad going and buy nutmeg by the pong now. Watch him.
Nutmeg like really?
Could you put a little bit of cinnamon inside there? We have some cinnamon right there. Cinnamon, one of those.
I like how you're thinking. I like
classical.
By a little
spices.
Bit of cinnamon, you mean all, right?
All? You see, this is why Christmas cooking is so easy.
Yeah, now. This thing looking real nice.
I can't
wait to see
so
what.
So awesome. And look at this beautiful bananas. You want to add them inside there?
Poutine.
Mix it up. Now, I want you to use a little bit of. Strength inside that. Come on.
A little bit of strength.
Because
we're going to mash up all these bananas and things inside
no,
here.
No, we ain't going to mash it up.
You're not going
to
mash
have
it up?
Respect for the you're bananas. Gonna, the bananas gonna... need to have the nice integrity.
Okay, all right.
Inside of it.
All right.
You ever hear a man talk about bananas having integrity?
What do you think now?
Vanilla.
Vanilla. Okay.
Vanilla. And some raisins.
Banana.
No.
Banana with integrity.
Making...
Hey,
don't be talking like that to me. I could kick you off this. Go. You come to parang my set and you come in and give me talk.
Listen. You are not kicking me off of this set. Right?
Well, then behave yourself, Conrad.
I will take the elevator back downstairs if you so desire that I leave. Right. Good.
So we're looking good there so far. We have our bread here.
Uh-huh.
We're going to actually add that into it. So nice. We have our banana rum raisin.
Bread pudding.
Bread pudding.
Right. Good. So
put the bread inside there. Conrad,
how much bread do you have?
We have 4 cups of bread inside here. But you ain't want no rum in this? You have rum? You have rum?
You are rum?
Rum. Glorious rum.
When I call you, you're bound to come. Yeah, where the rum? Where the rum it is?
We have the awesome Eldorado 5-star de Memara rum from Naughty Grape. Take your time,
brother. I'm going to do a little dance for that too.
This is awesome inside of our bread pudding.
Eldorado 5-star.
This is awesome inside of our bread pudding.
Right.
Because the nice dark notes inside of it really embodies it. And you get that nice rich flavor going on. You like that?
Like
keep
it.
That away from your mouth, Conrad. Could you put some inside there for me, Conrad?
Okay, fine.
Why people is always behave so bad for Christmas time,
okay.
Boy?
Gosh. You say some, right?
Let's put a little bit. Nice one. Tick, tick, tick. A little more, man.
Say when.
Alright. You want to drunk on the people?
No.
A little bit again, you're going to add the whole bottle, Conrad. Conrad, your kid's in trouble. Mix it up. Alright, so we're going with our bread. Mm-hmm. Now, this is just 4 cups of bread. This is more or less hops bread that I just cubed up.
Okay.
You could use any type of bread, but usually a nice kind of dry bread or stale bread works very well with inside.
Okay, cool.
Go through.
Alright. Alright,
take it then. Mix. You have a spatula right here. You're real incorrigible, boy. You're real incorrigible. I find that spatula.
Yeah, yeah, there's encouragement, nice.
I find that spatula actually matching your hands.
You see, I come with the intention to coordinate, right?
The man come with skills, boy.
Mix it. Whoom!
Beautiful. The rest of the bread.
Right.
Looking good?
Are we looking?
So the idea with this is that we made this nice little custard with our eggs, mm-hmm. our milk, our sugar, vanilla mm-hmm. essence, our nutmeg, our cinnamon, our rum, our right. raisins, mm-hmm. our bananas.
All right.
We're gonna put it inside it. And we don't want it to, you don't want to mush it too much because you still want the bread to okay. absorb some of that milk during while it cooks. So you get that nice formation of our bread pudding.
Okay.
Catch me?
So I don't have to moisten everything.
So you're looking good so far, right?
All right, good.
Awesome. So what I have here, ladies and gents, so far is actually a pan that I just greased with a little bit of oil. You could use a little bit of butter also.
Mm-hmm.
And this is to prevent the bread pudding from actually sticking.
Decent.
So you want to actually put this inside here for me? Pour it out.
Oh, good. Okay, I'm in. Nervous.
Let me let Tom see it. Tom is not go like that. Spray that out a little bit.
Ta-da! Boom, boom, boom,
it looking
boom,
good, boom, Conrad. Boom, you make this already,
boom, 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 boom. I find like I could do it more.
Oh, I don't know why this invites you for it.
You know exactly why. Boom, boom. That. You want a drunken people?
This is the best kind of rum. This one, naughty grape.
Let me drink some now. Let me drink.
All right. We'll make something after.
Gosh.
So we're looking good there, right?
Mm-hmm. Nice, good.
Beautiful. So you want to just make sure you arrange it nicely.
Okay,
you see all those nice little cubes of bread inside there? That's definitely going to give a lot of texture.
Yeah,
the little pieces of banana. Yes. The raisin, it's definitely attractive on the eye.
Yeah, so that's why I want to get some of them up to the top. You know what I'm saying?
All right. So I think we're ready to go in the oven.
Right.
I actually have my oven preheated to 350 degrees Fahrenheit, the same temperature with my ham. I'm going to put it inside. And this will take probably 25 to 30 minutes. Let's go.
Cool.
You want to help me?
What are we doing?
Into the oven. You can help me to it. So Conrad, bread pudding bubbling.
Nice.
Later on, we'll finish that up with some nice Ponche Crème ice cream.
Ponche Crème.
And a little bit of caramel sauce. Not like you had enough.
I'm not really a fan of ice cream, but you say Ponche Crème, I'll go try it.
Yeah, and in the amount of rum you put in that, oh Lord Jesus.
Right, I eat.
But you know what? Let me work on the glaze for the ham.
All right.
Working on a nice glaze. Very simple. I need you to help me.
Glaze for ham.
I have some time here.
Mm-hmm.
I have some
How much
brunch.
Time we have?
We can't waste time here.
We can't waste time? Right, good.
All right. So we have time. We have brown sugar. We have some honey.
All right.
Tom, nice honey looking good, huh?
That's
my middle name, you know? That's what the girls is called.
I'm not even going there. Too easy.
All right. Just pick some time here for me in the meantime. And this is just fine time.
In the meantime?
Tom,
fine time?
Some fine
make time?
I have some picked already, so I'm going to be adding it here inside.
All right.
So continue adding that.
All right.
I have some brown sugar, about 3/4 cups.
Mm-hmm.
Add it. And this is going to be an awesome glaze for our ham. Because you know the ham itself is salty. So this is going to bring a nice contrast of sweet and salty.
Yeah.
I have a half cup of
nice.
Honey, as I mentioned. And I am going to then just mix this together like that. Check that out, Tom. Looking good. You
it
can actually smell
hell good.
The honey inside there. And the
essence. All I smell in here is thyme though. Whoa.
You see, the thing about it is that actually when you bruise the thyme against the sugar,
mm-hmm.
you just get that essence coming through, that nice
pungency.
When
you say bruise, what's the verb you use?
Bruise. You're actually rubbing it against the abrasiveness of the sugar.
I'm learning so much.
Come now, you're wasting time. Push the thyme inside. Go.
All right now. Pishwell.
Right, so that is more or less done, our glaze. And mm-hmm. remember, the ham is actually hot. So when we brush this on, it's going to actually just melt all over it nicely.
Nice.
So we could actually put this to the side.
Cool.
And we'll deal with it.
So that's the whole glaze there?
That is the glaze for the ham. What else you want? You want nothing else again?
Wait. You're the first man I know. We're talking about ham, and I hear no mention whatsoever, and all you could follow me on this, make no mention of chow chow. I have a problem with that.
You like chow chow and ham? Right, for the first time for the whole day, you make sense.
Auntie.
But I call a partner. I know a chow specialist.
Uh-huh.
He will come. Let me call him and tell him.
Actually, we have no time. We just put all the time inside there. We have no more time.
No, this fella, he's a chow specialist. Not only that, he's running real fast. He got reaching out for now. Like the 4G network, you're real quick. Trust me.
Alright, I'm taking your word.
Alright, so he coming through now.
Right.
Coming through now. So he could make it chow or whatnot like that, so have no problem.
Right.
So
hey, what going on?
Hey, I tell you, the man reaching tutus.
Oh,
but
gosh.
You will you figure?
That's cool, yeah man.
It's
man.
Good friends I have, you know. Figures I just lying with you when I have faith, eh?
Wait, but I want to look like all this at the bubble without myself.
Come now, man.
We hear you is the chow specialist. Yeah, that's that.
Let me see your bubble. I mean, everything that you WhatsApp me in terms of what you wanted. I have
my onion.
I have my onions, garlic, pimentos, cinnamon, nutmeg. It's nutmeg, you say, right?
You don't know nutmeg.
Red wine vinegar. Pineapple juice, carrots. We have some cayenne.
Mm-hmm.
We have some mustard and pineapple.
Don't forget my onions.
Purple onions. Why do you use
purple
onions? You want anything to look pretty. Mine is purple onions.
I like it. Right?
Conrad, tone it down now. Gosh,
what,
Jehue,
what,
your man.
Easy, fine.
So, Jehue, let me start this chow, you know. Chow special.
Let me take all it through it.
All right.
So, we have a pot
on
the stove.
You can take us through it. I like this.
So, you have this pot on the stove, a medium saucepan.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. So, you're going to add.
On.
Yeah, boy, you're looking good right here. So you have some vegetable oil inside here. So you want to swirl it around.
Yeah,
all right. Nice. What you going with first?
Team onions.
So those are just diced white onions, right? Ooh, sizzle! Oh, good! We bubbling it up.
Right.
All the time thing going on.
At that level, cooks inside here.
Garlic. You even make the pot smell so since you come, Jay. You just come for 30 seconds and
take use
Pimentos.
But you need to have all those local flavors inside.
Stir that up, man. Get that flavor out there.
So you
smell
just,
that.
It's aromatic, huh? It's smelling
that.
Nice already. That's
Tom.
One of
Tom!
Oh my gosh.
That's what you should make air freshener, yeah?
Fine? With pimentos and garlic.
Yeah.
Jehue, I see you have pineapple here.
Yeah, man. We have to take care of that now.
So we doing with
while,
this?
Conrad,
mm-hmm.
help me neaten up them pineapples, but while just get a little chop up for me into some smaller pieces, man.
All right. I can help Jehue.
Fix up, man.
I know you're the chow specialist. give me some, and you take some. So you just want to cut up small then?
Just cut it up into some smaller pieces for me, please.
All right, cool. Pass a little night day for me, man.
There you go.
You're looking good there. No, me, I can cut like you, yeah?
Oh gosh, we in company right now.
While we had this going on.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
We have
spices right here.
Cinnamon and nutmeg.
Mm-hmm. Organized.
So that's important inside there, right? Right, Jehue? It's going to give some nice flavor.
It's a nice little flavor.
Nice flavor.
You know why it burned too much?
Mm-hmm.
So make sure and spin it up a little bit. Let's get a nice sweet scent about it.
You're making Conrad look real bad here right now, you know.
Smell that now.
Conrad Young in the game, still remember that.
Thanks, eh? Thanks. Thanks, Jehue.
Right. And I'm putting the cayenne powder.
Are we looking,
also.
Looking good?
It's a little bit of heat, so you have cayenne now. Ooh, looking good. Pineapple looking good. Put it back in your bowl now. Give it to Jehue.
All right.
Well, we can have him waiting, eh?
Yes.
Next thing we want to add.
He's a man of speed.
Red wine vinegar.
Yep.
So that's, you want a little bit of acid inside that?
Red wine vinegar.
Oh, yeah.
Juice.
Pineapple juice.
Put in. You've seen bubbling taking place there, Conrad?
I'm learning something. I like what I see.
Alright, we just gently stir it. We don't want to stick into the pot too much. Alright. Add the carrots.
Some diced carrots.
Scrape out all your carrots, man.
Don't waste that.
Leave nothing to waste.
You can't waste that.
All in no time.
See what going on there?
Can't leave nothing back at all to waste.
Right.
Good, man. Oh, so your pineapple is ready.
We?
Yes. We don't stick in. I'm with Conrad. I just stick.
Nice. Right.
Control yourself, man, Conrad.
Come to you, boy. Well put together here.
Mm-hmm.
Tom, nice small pieces of pineapple. Win the game.
Yeah, win the game.
So this is a pineapple. This is a pineapple chow then.
A pineapple chow.
But Jehue, this is a nice idea that Jehue come up with here, right? You're a chow specialist.
Is that interesting?
But I can't eat a ham without pineapple chow.
Alright.
Can't eat a ham without pineapple chow.
So not only the man good on the track and field, but he could bubble in the kitchen.
That we saying.
leave no stone unturned.
For who did not know? The young prince in the building right here. Oops. But right now, the pineapple chow chow.
What? Mm-hmm. I'm glad you come here to Parangi said to know. Because I wasn't getting all this kind
of... You're looking good. It's
looking good. Good, huh?
Yeah, yeah. It's smelling good, too.
You want to taste it, or what?
Huh?
You want to taste it, or it's too early still?
It's too early still. Crucial flavors need to be added before tasting. Yeah.
So, in addition to that, any other ingredients have to go inside
here? Gosh, man.
Like, I know chow chow always has some mustard inside of it and so forth.
Just the mustard and the onions. Take the spoon right here.
But we put white onions already, right?
Yeah, you want some white onions in there already.
What other onions you want?
Just the purple onions.
Ah, so this is what going to give what to the dish? Nice little bit of color.
Nice little bit of color. A little bit of crisp.
Oh, sweet. Yeah. So you have all the nice flavors of the pineapple juice inside. You have the red wine vinegar for the little bit of acidity. So you have sweet, aciduous.
Mm-hmm.
You have the pineapple for texture and also those beautiful onions.
Mm-hmm. And you're getting nice and savory from the
I'm getting it already. Smell, not going to
Yeah, smell.
If the people could
just pick up all the different flavors inside of here.
I put in a bag, he tells the difference.
Nice. All for your...
With Jehue? Mm-hmm. Like, let's know you will get wife, but...
yeah,
you might go in here right now.
I'm ready to play in house a long time, you know.
Yeah, all right.
Maybe Santa Claus will bring you again.
Let me see what gift Santa will bring for me.
Santa will get our wife.
Let me see what gift Santa will
Santa
bring.
Santa looking for a wife? What, Jehue looking for a wife?
Looking for a wife? Maybe we will be mobile, we'll find one for me.
Ay, ay, ay. They go find one for you fast.
So I guess you're just going to lead off about 2 to 3 minutes to just bubble down.
Right.
Just nice. bubble down a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll check back with it.
Yeah, man. I'll see.
Thanks,
cool.
Man.
Cool.
Well, Jehue, you're looking good there, boy.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
How years now it's done?
Now we see it bubble down. It's time for the final stage here. We want to season it up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
The volume has decreased.
Mm-hmm.
Just want to add a little black pepper right here.
So there's a little bit of spice then?
Just a little bit of spice, my friend.
It up.
Not too much.
Right?
Just a little spice.
Nice. Looking good,
sprinkle.
Right.
Mm-hmm. What are my secret ingredients to? See, where is my secret ingredient?
That is between two of you. I don't know what this is.
I don't know what you're talking about. The Maggi vegetable bouillon cube.
You make it sound like...
Conrad, this is between me and Jehue. Relax yourself.
Clearly.
So we have one Maggi vegetable bouillon cube inside here.
Real deal right here.
Nice.
So I see you're just mashing it up. You're dispersing it. So it's evenly distributed.
I'll give it some nice flavor.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's, you know, it's very comprehensive on the whole, eh?
Mm-hmm.
So one whole cube, nice, man.
Yeah, man, just sprinkle the rest over in there. Right?
Sweet. Yeah. That's a nice ingredient. I use it, you know, for a lot of ingredients, especially with savory preparations.
Mm-hmm.
I can see why you have
to. Just stay it around a little bit more.
Right. Yes. Make sure everything gets dispersed.
Sure everything is dispersed evenly.
Right.
Yes.
Pineapple looking good in that corner.
The whole thing looking good. I like all the colors and things.
This is not no ordinary chow chow, you know.
This is young prince chow chow.
Young prince chow chow. You're gonna come in with something else, or what?
Yeah.
The last thing is to add a little parsley to it.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So I think this is finished right here.
Take that off.
Right.
Right.
Let's add a little parsley to it.
A little pinch.
Oh, good, Tom. Get in that. I could try it.
Coloratement.
Right, they just add a little variance in the flavor.
Mm-hmm.
And some color as well.
And some color, my friend.
Yeah.
Voila.
In the show show.
Are you ready to put that on hops and ham, you know?
It is about that time.
Are you sure?
I am certain.
Jehue, what say you?
My belly is ready.
I'm smelling the ham. In the atmosphere. You wanna go check this? Let me go check this now.
Let's do this one, guys.
Let's go do this.
Pick up knives and let's go.
I go in with this.
Oh God, Lord. Oh Lord. Neighbor, oi. Bring out the ham. Like, are they real like nonsense in a way? Anything for a piece of ham, eh? You ready to glaze this? Conrad?
Yes.
What tell you about this bottle?
Nothing.
You ain't
tell me nothing about this
bottle. Conrad, come here for the bottle, man. You ain't come here for the ham.
Nothing about this bottle. Well, you want to help me glaze this thing?
Jehue,
we have this glaze we made earlier on, boy. Some brown sugar, some honey, and some thyme.
Look at that.
So we're just going to glaze it now.
We're gonna this is what you call sweet ham.
Sweet ham.
Sweet
Take
ham.
A spoon there, and I want you to put some on it. And we're just going to...
No problem.
And the heat of the ham will actually, like, cause it to... Conrad, you want to try? I will direct all you. Make sure it fold up all on the sides nicely. So what happened here is that the honey and the brown sugar coming together, the heat is going to disperse it evenly all over the ham.
Okay.
They're going to get those nice savory notes.
Do you just put
just
it on
a
top,
little bit of sweetness coming
through.
Rub
it, you could
rub
it
to the side and whatnot like that.
Nice.
So we have, this was actually 2 hours inside of the oven so far.
Uh-huh.
And we're going to finish out with the last half an hour with the glaze. So we're going to put this back into the oven. I think we're looking good, Jehue.
How long are you going to put this back in
about
the oven for?
About half an hour at the same temperature of 350 degrees Fahrenheit. You're going to leave it uncovered.
Okay. All right.
And you got to watch it because this has a significant amount of sugar on top of it.
Yeah.
And you don't want it to
burn. All right.
Yeah, you'll be looking good there, right?
Ready to go, man. Time to go back in the oven.
Look at that. Let me head through. Come.
Fellas.
Papaya.
Go
ahead. This is over.
What are we talking about there, now? Oh, God. Check. Thank you.
No, not you.
Mr. Diham?
Yes.
Mr. Diham.
Well, yeah. you jump on the bandwagon now with Conrad.
You ain't no hammy now. No bandwagon here.
So I think it's not over yet.
You know, it's Christmas and all kind of madness could happen here.
Oh. Look at that now. Look at that.
Mm. You see the nice cap on it? It's kind of a little bit of sticky, icky, which is nice because all that nice honey and brown sugar. What are you looking at there? I'm shaking your head.
We're having a romantic moment here.
You want to slice it up? We try.
You go through hard now. Our man head go for long and bounce this block here. And watch that now.
Mm. Oh, God, my eye and them dribble in.
Murder police.
Mm. Go away, father's going to taste this, yeah?
Mm. Look, you see this thing? But they get you come down, man. Is that knife I hold in, boy? Right.
You know what I'm saying, boy?
Nothing. I will taste it, too.
You want to taste it?
Yes.
That's how you go ask something to drink, too.
Yeah?
And we're gonna drink in the meantime.
All right, good, nice.
You wanna make some sandwiches?
Yeah, let me do that.
All right, Jay, you help him now. I make some sandwiches.
No worries. All right.
So pull out our hops there. Open that.
Let's start with the hops first.
Yeah.
Make this easier for you right here.
And then see if I could cut some nice burger slices for you.
Of course. That ain't looking sexy, boy.
That's what we say since 1975.
Thing happening on the side, you know.
Ain't no party like a bubble with us,
oh,
nice.
Boy.
So right. A nice. What are you talking about? What next one, man?
Don't worry yourself.
Chabba.
I'm taking care of the boys today.
Aye, aye, aye.
I'm taking care of the boys.
Right. Mm-hmm. Right. Good, good. A little greenery and well. Lash it.
My next piece on top of
it. No. Lash it with a... The specialty, the Young Prince Chow Chow.
Is that's the official name for it now?
Young Prince Chow Chow, boy.
Oh my gosh, bro.
Make sure I'm copyright. That you know, do you? Right, nice. Are we talking about? Look at that now.
That's a little bit more. And we're good to go.
Jason, look at that now. Take a look at that now. Tom, look at this. Present that.
Take a little zipping right there, Tom.
Jay, that's your Chow Chow? That looking so good.
Specialty chow chow.
All right. Boom!
Lord.
Boom!
I love it.
Boom!
I'm going to make two more for the boys.
We're going to eat, right?
Get the next one. We're done for
you, boy. Let me make my drink in the meantime, nevertheless. So what I have here is three flute glasses that I have. 1, 2, 3. And I have sorrel buds inside here. It's flowers and sorrel.
All right.
And the syrup is really concentrated and nice. So it's a sorrel concentrate that I have.
Mm-hmm.
And they have the buds that you could actually see inside of the fluted glasses so far. So it's a nice garnish.
All right.
So what I'm going to do is actually just take a little bit and pour some inside here like that.
Nice.
So about two. All right. Jay, you were drinking this too?
I'm not drinking anything right now.
Oh my gosh.
Nice.
Prosecco, ladies and gents. Italian sparkling wine from the Naughty Grape.
Nice. What exactly is Prosecco? Though?
Prosecco, let me start off first and foremost. You know, champagne
right.
from France.
Mm-hmm.
Anything that is made in the Champagne region of France is still champagne.
Okay.
Sparkling. If it's made outside of the Champagne region, it's known just as sparkling wine. The Italians' answer to that is that we're going to make our own sparkling wine, and we're going to call it Prosecco. This is what it is.
Right,
so we have our buds inside here, and our
Watch that. I like that.
You see how sexy that looking?
I will never drink ordinary Sorrel again.
It's swanky. Swanky. We are young prince in the house. Swanky. So you see the bubbles, right?
Yes, this is
our beautiful Prosecco.
I like it.
I love this one. I actually get it by Naughty Grape all the time.
Mm-hmm.
They have a really extensive collection of wines. Alcohol, red wines, white wines, Prosecco. So.
Yeah. I like Naughty Grape.
Beautiful. How are we looking? Nice, eh?
If I tell you, I never drink wine and hops before, eh? That's a first.
Well, this is only happening on Bubble with us.
Mm-hmm.
Hops ready?
Hops ready. Fellas. Hops loaded.
Fellas, Conrad?
Muchísimas gracias.
Jehue?
Mm-hmm.
Moi?
Yeah.
Are you ready to dig in? Yeah, take a toast now, man. To Bubble with us, the Christmas
to
season.
To Bubble with us. Thanks for running through, by Jehue.
Bubble we bubble in.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Wow. Today's a good day, you know. Today's a good day.
A nice relaxed day.
It's a nice relaxed day. Well, you want to try this hops? I can drink it.
You ain't got to tell me twice.
Oh, look, come, look at that now. That's beautiful. Look at that chow. Look at that.
That sandwich that we're talking about.
You ready?
I'm ready to eat long time. We can show up.
Put in it here.
Conrad.
Hey, these sound effects.
Jehue. Talk to him, tweet him.
Jehue. I like this show here, you know.
You know what I like about it, Jehue?
Wow.
Is that it's crisp. You get any tomatoes. The ham is beautifully cooked. It's not overcooked. Sometimes it's Christmas ham and it's dry. And that chow, just bring it on, but it lashes.
Finish it up.
By reason, listen, boy. This is a good episode here.
Let's know. What happened?
I realize we have banana bread pudding and thing here that we organize and thing.
We even finished the one bread pudding already?
No, I didn't say I want it. Hand me a banana.
Let me organize it. Hand me.
Let me deal with that bread pudding.
Trinidadians again.
Alright.
Conrad,
what?
I can understand all the fellas, you know. They don't eat half and they're ready
for speaking. It's sitting down there looking lonely. I decide to make it join the company.
Make some space for me.
All right.
Let me plate it out.
Okay.
Between you and Jehue come quiet on the show. And like, you just take him astray.
He come quiet, but you see all this?
He man hungry.
Right.
Clear hops. Let me go. Let me start to plate it up. Put our hops on that side here for me now.
Hey!
Stop yourself! Respective sandwich.
Stop yourself!
Steve, we have here going on, boy?
I thought that was my own, my bad.
Nah.
Steve, we have going on here? So, here were we, fellas. We're gonna do this.
What?
Our bread pudding. Are we looking there?
Good to go.
Looking good to go?
Good to win.
I'm gonna use a nice ring cutter.
Mm-hmm. Can I use a normal knife, boy? I think I see Tanti using a fork all kind of things.
Jehue, you're trying to make it a little more, you know. Sophisticated.
No, I
realize that Conrad have you on the wrong side. A nice piece like that. What do you feel about that?
Mm-hmm.
It's all good.
Oh, Lord.
Jehue.
Boy,
Jehue.
I will make a separate one for you.
I find you come here with your bad habits.
You know, it is like them children, they come the first day of school, they come.
Mm-mm.
10 minutes, that is it. And you break out.
Yeah.
You looking good there?
Yeah, man.
Ice cream. What do you say?
Ice cream?
Ponche creme ice cream. No, the Ponche creme ice cream. You can actually log on to www.bepartofit.com/bubble with us. And you get the recipe there for that. That and the caramel sauce that we're going to be using. Make sure you log on to that. Make it the ice cream.
Alright, this one. I like it now.
So this is nice Ponche creme ice cream.
Put this to rest here.
Oh, Jehue. Today's your lucky day, boy.
That is Ponche creme ice cream.
This is Ponche creme ice cream. Jehue.
If my coach only know why you're eating nowadays.
Jehue.
He fire, yeah.
Jehue.
Yeah, that's how you come here and join you.
Nice piece of banana on top like that. What are looking there?
That looking.
Some caramel sauce. Again, recipe online for this. Whoopsie.
Ah, you're not.
Ah, boy. Come down a little bit. That's alright.
No worry, we'll deal with that.
We'll deal with that. We can fix that up.
Shall be dealt with.
Shall be dealt with. Put that back on top like that. How are they looking there? Looking sweet.
I'm not really a dessert man, but you see that?
That's something that tends to make it look good, you know?
What that bite?
A nice piece of mint. We'll definitely bring this over.
Take a bite of ham on us for that.
A real fancy thing here, boy.
This is a nice garnish, Jehue.
Look at that. Tom?
That's pretty.
That's nice.
Banana, rum, raisin, bread pudding, ponche creme ice cream, caramel sauce. A nice piece of mint on top. Jehue, you want a piece of the salt? What is for Conrad?
Forget Conrad.
Use my guesses. I fed up with Conrad.
Yeah, Jehue, you go. Tell me what you have. I'm going to be over here.
The idea with this is that you get a nice warm bread pudding and that cold ice cream, that two sensations going on.
Mm-hmm.
And you see the bread is nicely crusted on the outside. Yeah, it has that nice vanilla inside there, bananas.
Nice and soft.
Mm-hmm. We have our Maggi coconut milk inside there.
What do you say there, Mike?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Oh, Lord. Watch now, Jehue. You coming for me now.
From the time I see the clothes right there, I know that's it there. It's all over.
You know it's serious on my eyes closed. Eh? Don't run
with your eyes closed, though.
Nah, don't worry.
Right. Good. As long
so
as
you like that, sir.
Yeah, man. Mm.
Beautiful. So I'm glad that you enjoy all the food that you know we made today. The ham and hops and that extraordinary chow chow that you made. The Young Prince Chow Chow.
Young Prince Chow Chow. TM.
TM. C-Mac Peter.
R. Peter.
A nice bread pudding. Conrad, you actually helped with this.
I did.
Ponche creme ice cream and the caramel sauce. Find it online. And I think, you know, all in all, it's an extraordinary bubble with us today right here on the Bmobile 4G network.
You forget the ham or what?
The ham in safekeeping. In safekeeping.
Okay.
You see what's going on here already? Men want to capitalize and take the ham on me already.
I don't blame them, no.
But this is what Christmas is all about. People always trying to take the ham, parang the wrong house, take your rum and everything. But nevertheless, thanks to my colleagues today for coming through and bubbling with me. Jehue,
man.
It's beautiful. Thanks.
It's nice meeting you.
I really appreciate it. I'm humbled by your presence.
No problem.
Conrad, even though you cause mischief and trouble.
That's what you just bring me here for, though.
So you enjoy that?
I enjoy that. All I have to say is Merry Christmas.
And welcome all of us here from the Bmobile Network. Have a very Merry Christmas. And look out for us. Season 2 coming.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Right. Merry Christmas. How are we saying?
Remember earlier on I told you all about a certain type of sparkling wine we used in this preparation? You all know what it is? Post your answer to www.bepartofit.com/bubblewithus. Tell us, what was the name of this particular sparkling wine that we used?
Mm-hmm.
Do you remember? Mm-hmm. Gamish, go tell them. Post your answer. Merry Christmas.
Bmobile.